Hello, beta testers. Finding the differences between two pictures is something a toddler can do. When you realize some people in the Avengers community aren't even capable of something so simple, you start to understand why the defenders get so mad. So, I want to apologize. I didn't know they didn't possess the faculties to discern. I overestimated. And that was wrong of me. I hope that they're no more angry with me than they are with a dictionary, because I didn't choose the definition of the word clown, but they chose to be one. Accurate is defined as correct in all details, exact. There are Marvel games with comic book accurate skins. Marvel's Avengers is not one of them. Viewers, if someone claims that these are comic book accurate to you, don't waste the brain cells trying to lower yourself to that level. Leave it alone. They clearly need whatever satisfaction that this imaginary W would bring them. Pray for these defenders. People come to me because they know that I'll be real with them, and the realest thing I can tell you right now is that if you listen closely, you can hear the Marvel's Avengers developers laughing at you. If you think it's a coincidence that they happen to choose the inferior, unpopular, and frankly laughably ugly Ultimate Iron Man redesign, not even the original, not the one that people know that's recognizable, that'll come up first when you Google it, or has been in cartoons or other games, but the absolutely unappealing retconned Iron Man, only to flex on the marketplace page with the normal Ultimate design on a card? I don't know what to tell you. They still haven't even mentioned the perks not activating after the patch they broke it with over 2 weeks ago. And you know that if they do, it won't be in a tweet, because damage control. Marvel's Avengers developers' choices have long been more fun to watch than this game is to play. Live services are supposed to have updates, right? 6 months later. You ever look at the comments on that Hawkeye War table? Let's do it together.
We were attacked by a race called the Kree. Of course we didn't really fight back, because it really shocked us when they weren't robots. We didn't really know what to do, because we've only ever fought robots. That's how we all died.
They should have released Scarlet Witch while WandaVision is in the middle of its season. LOL. That dog animation was a representation of this game. Look, guys, even more robots to eliminate, as if we didn't have enough of them. Congratulations to all 6 people still playing this. Your dedication has been rewarded. In a month, not now, in a month. I just wish they didn't release 2 archers in a row, oops, all archers. The Kree have invaded Earth. Fights aimbots. Oh damn. This game needs more bosses and more enemy variety. They lost me when they announced Hawkeye, and then Hawkeye. Remember 6 months ago when they showed us a man and then they gave us a woman? They gave us our man. They gave us our man. Fans, this game really needs more variety if I'm gonna come back to it. Devs, second bow and arrow character. When you think superhero, you think archer. Am I wrong? Would you allow Crystal Dynamics to be in charge of a child's birthday party? I like this one. 5 months later and we still can't replay the campaign. 5 months later and there's still only 2 villains to fight every day on repeat. This would be funny if it wasn't so sad. Who does this guy and his facts think he is? Toxic? Hater? What was this, some kind of Kyle subscriber in here? Kyle here, and I'm not going to overproduce this video. If you've played a video game in your life with a boss fight, odds are you've encountered phases, mechanics. Maybe there are times that you can damage them, times that you can't. Maybe the environment comes into play and it's the only way you can inflict damage, or you have to move to avoid the damage. In Marvel's Avengers, standing around a dude and wailing on them is 100% of the battle. And if you're a tryhard who had tons of time to sink into grinding for the right gear, or if you're just lucky enough to get drops that complement a crazy build, you could probably insta-kill some of these damn bosses. If the game's perks aren't being broken by patches that Crystal Dynamics put out and has yet to acknowledge over 2 weeks later. But you know what? That's fine for some of the defenders of this game who can never even acknowledge anything negative, even if it means watching Crystal and their choice to not communicate kill any chance of this game having a future. If that's not toxic positivity, I don't know what is. These little kids try so hard to make Kyle a villain, and I was glad to be one, since they clearly weren't going to be getting one from this game. But we're swiftly approaching I Told You So season, and after a month, when they finally dump out Hawkeye, you'll have to wonder if they'll even worry about bug fixing before they figure out throwing out Spider-Man, maybe Black Panther, just to fulfill their obligations and wash their hands of this mess. The Harm Room could so easily have been transformed into Asgard, Wakanda, Atlantis, the Helicarrier, which was in the game, but you can't replay the game, so you can't replay the Helicarrier. It could have been anywhere in space. The Holographic Room, instead of being a holodeck from Star Trek, or the Danger Room from the same universe, X-Men. It's just this stale-ass holographic room, and it's remained this way for 6 months. Broke-ass Avengers. There could and should have been dozens of villains with how boring and lame these fights are, but nope. That would have been too much work. Broke, lazy-ass Avengers. This game needed a patrol mode. How you gonna try to copy Destiny and leave out patrol? There should not have been caps on faction experience, and people should have been receiving rewards every time they leveled up after level 50, just like you've heard me advocating about for over 4 months everywhere. Stop capping the factions, give people their rewards, acknowledge these people playing your stale-ass game. These rescue the hostage missions, they should have been refreshing. These high-priority targets, they should have been respawning the way that they were in the beginning of the game. Dia and I were playing that before you patched it. You patched out the respawning enemies because you have to increase the grind. Wouldn't want anybody gearing up too fast, would we? You were quick to patch it. But you're not so quick to patch any of this other shit. You're not even quick to acknowledge the issues. Because I guess nobody cares. I care enough to make sure your bitch ass doesn't get forgotten for who you are. Mean, broke, lazy ass Avengers developers. The icing on the cake is your silence. It's a middle finger to your remaining players who are having a worse experience, a more restricted, a more limited experience, a needlessly time-consuming experience with them employing workarounds and fixes to shit that you broke that should just work and did before. But you're not even gonna say anything about it. Do you deserve these players, Crystal Dynamics? Do you deserve to profit, Crystal Dynamics? Do you deserve the attention for any future product you release before apologizing? Before some form of compensation? You don't. And you know that you don't. Your behavior here is unbelievable. Viewers, this situation is sad, but it's even more sad for the types of people who, for whatever reason, are so tied up in this that their happiness is intertwined with whether or not this is doing well or perceived to be doing well. And I finally understand. The same types of dudes that are out here going, look, it's a good skin, see, they finally have a good skin. These are the types of people who are just looking for anything.
And that's why they're so mad at this dude, who is spitting the facts, who is just holding up a mirror to what's going on, who is giving you an English description that is factual according to dictionary definitions of terms. And that's enough for them to lose their minds. But I'll tell you what, I ain't going anywhere. Love you. Bye.